Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, in the name of Allah, the Gracious, the Merciful. Connect to Allah, because this line is never busy, always answered, no hang-up, no heartbreak. Allah has made it easy. So, read Quran with translation. Today we are going to discuss lymph nodes, most widely distributed, easily accessible, frequently examined for diagnostic purposes. Lymph nodes are found all over the body, commonly for diagnostic purposes. Cervical or axillary lymph nodes are examined. Lymph nodes are discrete structures encapsulated, contain B cell and T cell zones. Normal lymph nodes are not palpable. Only when they are swollen, they get enlarged and palpable. This is the normal histology of a lymph node. A capsule, there is a subcapsular sinus, follicles with germinal center, cortex and medulla. So it is a bean shaped structure. There is only one row of germinal center in the cortex. Medulla consists of medullary sinuses and they are surrounded by capsule. Now there are many different causes of lymph node enlargement. When there may be reactive hyperplasia, maybe follicular hyperplasia or sinus hyperplasia, lymphadenitis, acute and chronic, lymphomas, the malignant proliferation of white blood cells, or metastatic disease give rise to enlargement of the lymph node. Acute lymphadenitis, usually patient presents with infection of teeth or tonsils. Cervical lymph nodes, they become swollen and painful. So because the draining, when there is infection in the head and neck area, the draining lymph nodes produce drain microbes and they produce antibodies. Common causes of swollen cervical lymph node is bronchitis, common cold, ear infection, scalp infection, strep throat, tonsillitis, and any dental infection or infection in the mouth. So when there is inflammation, acute inflammation, there is redness, there is swelling and pain. Microscopically, there are prominent germinal centers of primary follicles. There is inflammatory necrosis, neutrophilic infiltrate, and sometimes the lymph node converted into bag of pus. Chronic non-specific lymphadenitis, repeated infection can lead to follicular hyperplasia, tingival body macrophages, paracortical hyperplasia or sinus histiocytosis. So in reactive follicular hyperplasia, variably sized reactive germinal centers scattered throughout the lymph node, and they have prominent germinal centers. In sinus histiocytosis, there is proliferation of macrophages lining the sinusoids, and tingival body macrophages means simply stainable macrophages. They contain debris and apoptotic cells, chromatin fragments. Usually when the primary infection subsides, the lymph node disappears. So in acute lymphadenitis, there is no need for biopsy. Usually when the infection is treated with antibiotics, there is disappearance of the swollen lymph nodes. So in the next video, we will discuss chronic lymphadenitis. So watch next video as well. Subscribe the channel, like and share this video.